Welcome to the NewsX Sunday Guardian Roundtable. Well, Jyotiradithya Scindia has left the Congress. He's joined the BJP. Social media is, of course, calling it Jexit. And that is something we are going to be discussing on Roundtable today. A, what will be the impact on the Congress? Some people are saying that, well, it's time that Rahul Gandhi takes the reins because the young guard is feeling isolated. But is that too simplistic an answer? A, what is stopping Rahul Gandhi from taking the reins earlier? And B, is there really this divide between the old guard and the young guard? Or is it something that is very conveniently passed off simply because of the fact the younger lot don't have it in them? I mean, look at the younger lot. Ajay Makhan versus Sheila Dikshit, Scindia versus Kamal Nath or Digvijay, Pilot versus Gehlot, we have Ashok Tanwar versus the Hoodas, Sidhu versus Captain Amrinder Singh, you do the maths. But this is something we are going to be figuring out on Roundtable, as I said. Joining me is Nirmal Pathak. He is the editor, PTI Bhasha. We have Kaveri Bamzai. She's an author and a columnist. Radhika Ramasation, consulting editor with Business Standard and also a columnist. And Pankaj Vora, he's managing editor of Sunday Guardian. Radhika, the impact of Scindia leaving the Congress, what message does it send?
Yeah, initially I thought it would be a symbolic kind of thing, but obviously it's gone beyond that. And you know, you saw the immediate impact in the choice of the Rajya Sabha candidates.
Dipinder Hooda,
Bharat Singh Solanki, who's like a proven loser. He's been losing election after election in Gujarat. Shakti Singh Gohil, ditto. He's never sort of kept his seat in Bhavnagar for years. So you've sort of rewarded these two characters. Then you have Rajasthan, you know, where you've gone some way to please Ashok Gehlot, but not entirely. And because Sachin Pilot wanted his person, a Dalit or an ST, I mean, that hasn't quite happened. So Rajasthan still remains a bit iffy. But the point is that the regional leaders have managed to have some say in the choice of the Rajya Sabha candidates. So that is where you're feeling the immediate impact. Now, long term, as you rightly said, it's being projected as a conflict between the old guard and the new Turks. Actually, new Turks would be an inappropriate term because I don't know if any of these guys are capable of really waging a revolt. And a revolt would mean starting your own party. I don't think they have the stomach for that kind of thing. So anyway, it's between the Rahul's contemporaries and Sonia loyalists.
Yeah.
You rightly said that's a very simplistic way of looking at it, you know, because all said and done, Sonia's loyalists still have a strong, deep base in the organization, which goes right up to the grassroots. They understand block level politics, district level politics. These young Rahul's peers have been given enough and more time to prove themselves. They've had ministries and everything, you know, and they just haven't. I mean, if the Congress looks like it's within sight of power, then they come into action, hoping to get some position or the other. Otherwise, where on earth do they disappear? I mean, Jitin Prasad, where is he? I mean, he should be right there in UP. I mean, the ground is fertile for taking on the Yogi government, but he's not anywhere around. RP and Singh, okay, he worked for a bit in Jharkhand, but I still think the Jharkhand victory was entirely due to Hemant Soren. And if anyone else tries to take credit, it's a bit duplicitous.
Kaveri, your first take, because you know it is true, the Gen X, because they're all their dynasts and they are their father's children, they've all studied abroad, they're dynasts and also Harvard, Stanford, here, there, nobody is zameen se juda hua neta, and now you want to get your father's glory and say I think
the point is that they all feel that there's a glass ceiling in the Congress, that you know only the Gandhis can become leaders. But there's a glass ceiling in the BJP as well. Do they think that they will ever replace Modi and Shah? You know, so they have to understand that. And I think Jyotiraditya has to understand that there are already two Scindias in the BJP. They've not exactly covered themselves in glory. Vasundhara Raje was not exactly the favorite of Modi and Shah. She was defeated. You know, his other aunt is all right. She's a minor leader. So I think for Sindhya to assume that he will achieve in the BJP what he did not in the Congress, I think is really something that is very, very far-fetched. And I think the point there is because he's not exactly a mass leader. The fact is that he did lose his constituency. Now he can blame the fact that he had to babysit Priyanka Gandhi Vadra in UP. But exactly what did he achieve in UP as well? So the fact is that these guys do not have the guts and the stomach to form their own political party. His father did it. Whether he succeeded or not is another thing. Mamata Banerjee did it. Sharad Pawar did it. YSR's son did it. You know, even if you look at legacy politicians, YSR's son did it. But he worked so hard for it. He went on that Udaipur Yatra and covered so much ground. Does Jyotiraditya have that kind of stomach for a long, long fight? If they accuse Rahul Gandhi of being a weekday politician and a sometime politician, that's exactly what these guys are as well. I think Radhika made that point. Where are all the leaders from Uttar Pradesh? Why are they not fighting the Yogi government? Why have they left this entire battle on CAA and NRC to civil society? Where are any of them in the public domain fighting for the citizens of this country? And then they expect to swoop down and claim the spoils of victory. I think that is what I find unacceptable. I want to make another point. This whole idea of entitlement, you know, Rahul Gandhi has one kind of entitlement. I went to college with him and we all know that they all went to Stevens only for less than a year. Priya, you should know you were there. Jyotiraditya has this royal entitlement. I mean, you're fighting a battle of two entitled gentlemen. You know, Rahul has his own kind of royal entitlement because he belongs to the Gandhi family. Jyotiraditya has his own kind of entitlement. This India has moved on from the politics of entitlement. They don't get that. And that is what is worrying. So wherever they go, whichever party they join, they will find that they will be out of place. They will have to work very hard. They will have to stop being entitled. They will have to work through the week, through the year, through the month, and like an Amit Shah.
Especially on the holidays.
Especially on holidays.
That lesson Sindhya learned. He chose early to go.
Well, anyway, I don't actually think it's a very big loss to the Congress. But then the Congress itself is, you know, quite
hardly in a position.
The loser, yeah.
Nirmal, you know, how will Sindhya be the impact on the Congress? I think, is he a big loss? And B, BJP me kaisa hoga? Because he went there, he quickly shed the Maharaj title. First thing he said in Bhopal is, ki do log without AC gaadi mein jaate hain, me and Shivraj Singh Chauhan. So he's also realized that ye entitlement Maharaj yahan hi chalega.
वो जो कावीर ने कहा है एग्री भी था कि बहुत लॉन्ग टर्म में कोई बहुत ज़्यादा इम्पैक्ट नहीं, शॉर्ट टर्म जरूर है. अभी वहाँ मध्य प्रदेश में सरकार बचेगी या नहीं बचेगी ये अभी उस पर डाउटफुल है, पर लॉन्ग टर्म में देखिए वो सिंधिया का एक लिमिटेड मध्य प्रदेश में अपना एरिया है जहाँ उनका इन्फ्लुएंस है, वहाँ वो प्रभाव जरूर डालते हैं. पर पूरे मध्य प्रदेश में जब ये मध्य प्रदेश के चुनाव हो रहे थे उस समय मैंने वहाँ एक वो महाराजा नरसिंहगढ़ जो दिग्विजय को भी उतने ही वेल विशर थे और सिंधिया के भी आप जानते हैं, तो मैंने उनसे पूछा था कि कांग्रेस क्यों नहीं सिंधिया को चीफ मिनिस्टर प्रोजेक्ट कर रही है, तो उन्होंने कहा कि सिंधिया की पॉपुलैरिटी है पूरे स्टेट में, उनको जानते हैं लोग अच्छी तरह से और वो एक अच्छा फेस हैं, पर उनके साथ दिक्कत ये है कि वो किसी को नहीं जानते कांग्रेस में. और दिग्विजय सिंह के साथ ये एडवांटेज है कि वो दिग्विजय सिंह सबको जानते हैं लेकिन वो पॉपुलर नहीं है, तो कांग्रेस के सामने ये बहुत कॉम्प्लिकेटेड सिचुएशन है. इसलिए कमलनाथ को वहाँ चीफ मिनिस्टर प्रोजेक्ट किया गया. तो इसलिए सिंधिया का कोई बहुत ऐसा इन्फ्लुएंस होगा ऑल ओवर स्टेट वो मुझे भी नहीं लगता है. पर अभी उन्होंने क्योंकि मध्य प्रदेश में कांग्रेस संकट में है और यहाँ बीजेपी में कितना जो उनका अप्रोच और एटीट्यूड जो सिंधियाज लेके आते हैं वो किस तरह से बीजेपी उनको झेलेगी और वो किस तरह से बीजेपी को झेलेंगे, जो आपने उनको नड्डा को सुना होगा उसी दिन जो उन्होंने कहा कि हमारे यहाँ किसी के साथ कोई भेदभाव नहीं होता, सब बराबर के लोग हैं, हमारे यहाँ कार्यकर्ता भी अध्यक्ष बन सकता है. एक मैसेज था सिंधिया को कि जो आप एक जो एंटरटेनमेंट वाली बात हो रही थी वो आप यहाँ पर अगर नहीं दिखाएंगे तो ज़्यादा अच्छा होगा. फिर आप शिवराज सिंह का भाषण सुनिए, मैं उसी दिन जिस दिन सिंधिया ज्वाइन कर रहे थे उसी दिन एक बीजेपी के वर्कर का, दिल्ली के एक बीजेपी के वर्कर का ट्वीट देख रहा था, वेलकम ब्रो इन द बीजेपी। तो अगर वो मिलके अगर सिंधिया को कहेंगे कि वेलकम ब्रो, तो मेरे ख्याल से सिंधिया अगले 6 महीने तक उनसे हाथ नहीं मिलाएंगे। तो ये प्रॉब्लम बीजेपी में उनके साथ होगी। और शिवराज सिंह ने कल जो वहाँ भाषण दिया है ज्योतिरादित्य सिंधिया को वेलकम करते हुए, उन्होंने कहा कि लंका ढहाने के लिए हमको विभीषण की ज़रूरत थी। तो एक तरह से वो कह रहे हैं कि ये सिंधिया जी हमारे लिए विभीषण साबित हुए हैं। तो इस तरह की चीज़ें अभी आने वाले समय में होंगी, पर सिंधिया के पास भी कोई अब ऑप्शन नहीं है, उनके वापसी का बहुत कम चांस है। जिस तरह की एक कटुता उनके जाने समय
हाथ साफ कर दिया,
राहुल गांधी तो चाहेंगे अगर सिंधिया कोशिश करेंगे तो राहुल गांधी हो सकता है ले लें वापस। अच्छा। लेकिन राहुल गांधी की कितनी चलेगी कांग्रेस में ये भी वो है, उसको लेके फिर मध्य प्रदेश में किस तरह का रिएक्शन होगा, दिग्विजय सिंह और कमलनाथ उनको एक्सेप्ट करेंगे या नहीं करेंगे, वो बहुत बड़ा सवाल होगा। पर बीजेपी के लिए वो ज़रूर एक एसेट साबित हो सकते हैं, क्योंकि बीजेपी में एक आप सेंट्रल मिनिस्ट्री में देख रहे हैं कि एक टैलेंट शॉर्ट उनके पास है, डेफिसिट है उसमें, और ज्योतिरादित्य के पास एक्सपीरियंस है, वो सेंट्रल में मिनिस्टर रह चुके हैं, इकोनॉमी उनका फेवरेट हाँ, तो अगर उनको कोई इकोनॉमिक मिनिस्ट्री वगैरह मिलती है हो सकता है उसमें वो ठीक ठाक परफॉर्म करें। उनका यूपीए में एज मिनिस्टर उनका रिकॉर्ड बहुत ख़राब नहीं था, तो वो बीजेपी के लिए एक फ़ायदे का सौदा हो सकता है। पर वो मध्य प्रदेश में तभी तक फायदे का सौदा होगा जब तक ज्योतिरादित्य सिंधिया मध्य प्रदेश में इंटरफेयर नहीं करेंगे। मध्य प्रदेश में अगर उन्होंने इंटरफेयर शुरू किया तो फिर उनके लिए भी दिक्कत होगी, क्योंकि शिवराज सिंह चौहान, कैलाश विजयवर्गीय, बीजेपी में मध्य प्रदेश बहुत स्ट्रांग लीडर्स उनके पास हैं, और कांग्रेस ज्योतिरादित्य वहाँ आगे अगर 5-6 साल रह जाते हैं तो ज्योतिरादित्य के लिए बीजेपी में भी फ्यूचर है। हो सकता है आगे वो चीफ मिनिस्टर कैंडिडेट वहाँ हो सकते हैं, क्योंकि बीजेपी की ये जो फर्स्ट लाइन ऑफ लीडरशिप है अभी शिवराज सिंह चौहान या कैलाश विजयवर्गीय वाली, वो भी अगले 4-5 साल में बाहर होने वाले हैं। तो सिंधिया के लिए वहाँ अपॉर्चुनिटी है, पर ऐसा नहीं है कि कांग्रेस वहाँ बिल्कुल ही ख़त्म होने वाली है। कांग्रेस के पास भी उतनी ही मजबूत सेकेंड लाइन ऑफ लीडरशिप है, जितने अभी मिनिस्टर्स हैं 2022 में, उसमें दिग्विजय सिंह के बेटे से लेके गए और इंदौर के जीतू पटवारी और बहुत सारे उमंग सिंघार हैं, ऐसे बहुत सारे नेता हैं जो आगे पोटेंशियल जिनमें है। तो ये अभी जो इमीडिएट लॉस है वो कांग्रेस का है, आगे किस तरह से पॉलिटिक्स प्ले करती है, क्योंकि जब तक फाइनल कुछ नहीं होता तब तक आप पॉलिटिक्स में कुछ कह भी नहीं सकते हैं।
वही सही है। बट पंकज, ये राहुल की टीम से जिसने बात करी, उनका कहना है कि जिसको जाना है जाए, इज दिस द राइट एटीट्यूड?
Well, personally speaking, you know, Sindhya's going away is not going to make much of a difference. Number two is that, you know, Sindhya, I think, has committed a huge mistake. He would have had a larger say in the Congress, which he can ever have. You know, if you compare it in BJP, he's not going to have the same sort of a clout which he enjoyed in the Congress because of his proximity to the first family. Now, Rahul's people, who, you know, they have no stakes. I mean, it is ki koi ja raha hai, jaane do. So, I mean, the party is over. You know, if you look at now, again, the Rajya Sabha list, it reflects, you know, what you call fights and struggles within the family, the power struggle which is going on within the family. Priyanka wanted 2 tickets, KTS Tulsi, because he is Robert Vadra's lawyer, and she wanted Rajiv Shukla, who, you know, against whom there was a revolt in Gujarat. You know, Rahul got 2 tickets, one for Venu Gopal, and the second for Rajiv Satav, who has only won 1 Lok Sabha elections. And, you know, there was no need. At one point of time, it was being said that he should have gone to become an MLC in Maharashtra. But now, since Maharashtra government's own future is going to be uncertain after a few months, so he's, you know, opted for the Rajya Sabha. You know, Sonia Gandhi continues to have this obsession with minorities and Dalits. You know, out of the 12 seats which were declared yesterday, 6 are, you know, either minorities or Dalits. And I don't know where the party is headed. Then, you know, basically, if all these things would never have happened had Rajiv Gandhi's, you know, basic principle of not giving tickets to defeated Lok Sabha candidates would have been implemented. You know, this rule, which was even continued during P.V. Narasimha Rao's time, got broken when Sonia took over, when she gave tickets to Oscar Fernandez, Shivraj Patil, P.M. Sayed to begin with. And, you know, they had all been defeated in Lok Sabha. After that, you know, now most of the people who have come, if they can't win their own, they have been rejected by the people. Why should they think of coming to the Rajya Sabha? Where is the logic? Where is the political logic? You know, this is where the party is, you know, just not going in a consistent manner. Now, you know, a lot of things are happening. Sindhya, of course, is a very high profile leader in terms of media projection. But whether, you know, if he is given a ministry in BJP, we'll see how efficient he proves, because, you know, he will be on trial there. And his going there is to the BJP is not made many people happy within the BJP also. As Nirmal was saying, there are people who right now have immediate ambitions of, you know, retaining power. And so far, the Prime Minister has not tweeted, you know, welcoming Sindhya. So, you know, there are going to be roadblocks there also. And his own aunts may not be happy, because, you know, he will deprive them. Once Sindhya has got something, so why should another get it? So the Sindhyas are not a pan Madhya Pradesh, you know, family, and it is basically they are, you know, confined to the Gwalior region, the Rajwada, and, you know, lot of things are coming up in politics. There's a senior Congress leader who is in charge of one of the states, you know, that particular person recently said that, you know, right now the days of the dynasts are over. It is us royals who will now, you know, take charge. So there is a tussle going at several levels. So let's see how things pan out.
Radhika, more going on now, what does the Congress do? You know, do they bring in Rahul sooner than later? Do they hold elections to the CWC, promote a second rank? They should do it, but will they?
They should. I mean, logically, you should hold an election, but I doubt. The last election was when Rajesh Pailit and Narasimha Rao's time, and even that was
Sonia
a bit…
Sonia Gandhi's time,
and even that really didn't…
To party president.
That didn't really
Jitin Prasad.
That didn't really change the dynamic within the Congress. So, ideally, yes, of course. But then, you know, does the BJP ever elect its president through a process of election? Never, you know. So, I think no party would want to take that route.
But, Kavi, seeing the BJP role to outsiders, you know, I was talking to a BJP, he's saying Amit Shah and Modi are promoting people where loyalty is more important than ideology. So, you have a Sindhya, like you have a Hardeep Puri, you have a MJ Akbar, you know, they were given ministerial posts. And, you know, people who are loyal to these two more than to the party.
But beyond a point, you cannot grow. Look at the last big asset that they had, Himanta Biswa Sarma. Of course, he won them half of the Northeast. But the fact is that Himanta Biswa is a shadow of his former self. He is nothing, you know, the power he wields is nothing compared to the power he wielded when he was Tarun Gogoi's right-hand man. He has to look at Amit Shah for everything to be cleared. He cannot take a step without Amit Shah clearing things. We saw that recently when he was trying to come to the center. So, I mean, if you have a really popular leader with deep pockets like Himanta Biswa Sarma, reaching a roadblock, reaching the glass ceiling, how does a person like Jyotiraditya Sindhya, despite, of course, wanting to fulfill his grandmother's legacy. Suddenly, everybody wants to be the grandson. He wants to be the grandson rather than the son. Mm. You know, in the Congress, he was the son. Here, he's, the return of the prodigal grandson, as his aunt said. But how does he hope to do anything that will be even a fraction of what Himanta Biswa Sarma has delivered to the BJP? So, I really don't think that these outsiders have much of a future. Within the BJP, we see people who do not have the RSS background have always suffered. So, these are people who do not even have a BJP background. How do they hope to go beyond a certain point? It baffles me. And I think the only thing that of note that Rahul Gandhi said recently was to retweet his old tweet about patience and time. You really need patience and time in today's politics. I think Congress for so many years, for decades, embodied what India wanted. This is the time when the BJP is embodying what India wants. Whether we like it or not, it has been able to capture the imagination of a large majority of Indians. Mm. you have to have patience and time in such a time. The Congress will come back at some point, but not with this kind of effete leadership. It needs a leader, because now we are in complete personality-driven politics. You look at all the regional parties, you look at a party like AAP as well, which was not supposed to be all about personality politics. It's only about personality politics. If you can, you know, gather enough of a flock behind you, you become a leader. But it is not really ideology driven, except in the BJP, which is completely and sharply ideologically driven. That's why you'll always have a glass ceiling for outsiders. Outsiders even to the RSS. Hmm. So that's an important point to remember.
Okay, good point. But back to the Congress, Nirmal, same thing happened with Madhav Rao. He wanted to be Chief Minister, Digvijay, Arjun Singh, everybody stopped him us samay. But he didn't leave the party, he didn't do a revolt, he found his own niche at the center. Because there is no central government, if Congress was in power, then Sindhya would have been happy being a minister. So he's really gone for the office.
But उसमें ये भी जब माधव राव सिंधिया को ये feeling जो अभी ज्योतिरादित्य के बाहर जाने से एक feeling जो state में लोग उनके workers के बीच में है वो ये कि पिछले 40 साल से सिंधियाज को लगातार humiliate किया जा रहा था. जो अभी ज्योतिरादित्य का जो डिसीजन हुआ है उसके पीछे एक रीजन वो भी है. वो कहते हैं कि माधव राव सिंधिया 89 में जब उनका चीफ मिनिस्टर बनने का टाइम था, व्हेन अर्जुन सिंह वाज आस्क्ड टू स्टेप डाउन, उस समय अर्जुन सिंह और शुक्ला ब्रदर्स उन्होंने मिलके सिंधिया को रोका. बाद में फिर 93 में जब कांग्रेस वहाँ आई फिर से पावर में, तो उस समय दिग्विजय सिंह, अर्जुन सिंह और कमलनाथ इन्होंने सिंधिया को नहीं बनने दिया. तो वो एक फीलिंग है उसमें, पर वो जैसे वो जो राहुल गांधी का ट्वीट टाइम एंड पेशेंस, तो वो उसमें पिक्चर में सिंधिया और कमलनाथ दोनों हैं, तो कमलनाथ का पेशेंस अल्टीमेटली पेड,
ही इज आल्सो वेटेड अ लॉट. हां,
कितनी, आई मीन फॉर हाउ
टाइम, टाइम इज ऑन साइड ऑफ ज्योतिरादित्य सिंधिया, तो ही शुड हैव आल्सो वेटेड फॉर हिज टाइम.
उसका
बिल्कुल. और अभी 18 साल हुए कांग्रेस में आए हुए, वो सोचते हैं कि जहाँ से उनके फादर ने छोड़ा था वहाँ से वो शुरू करें, तो वो नहीं होता है. 18 साल में आपको कैबिनेट मिनिस्टर आपको बना दिया, मिनिस्टर ही वाज मिनिस्टर स्टेट इंडिपेंडेंट इन चार्ज, तो उससे ज़्यादा और क्या चाहिए आपको. लेकिन जब तक आप मेहनत स्टेट में, उनको पीसीसी ऑफर हुआ था, ये दिग्विजय सिंह ने कहा है ऑन रिकॉर्ड, पीसीसी ऑफर हुआ था और डिप्टी चीफ मिनिस्टरशिप उनको ऑफर की थी जब अभी गवर्नमेंट बनी, पर वो किसी और को बनाना चाहते थे, पीसीसी प्रेसिडेंट भी और डिप्टी सीएम भी, तो उसके लिए कमलनाथ तैयार नहीं हुए. ऐसे सिचुएशन में कैसे आप सोचते हैं कि हर तरह से आप ही को सुना जाएगा, और कांग्रेस इस तरह की पार्टी नहीं है. कांग्रेस में बेसिकली प्रॉब्लम कांग्रेस के साथ ये हो रही है कि उसमें कांग्रेस लीडर ओरिएंटेड पार्टी है, पावर ड्रिवन पार्टी है. और जब लीडर भी नहीं हो, पावर भी नहीं हो, तो कांग्रेस में इस तरह की प्रॉब्लम्स हमेशा होती हैं. राजीव गांधी के बाद, राजीव गांधी, इंदिरा गांधी के बाद से कोई लीडर नहीं है, पर राजीव गांधी का टाइम अगर आप मान लें, तो उस समय राजीव गांधी अपने सेकंड टर्म के लिए एक लीडर के तौर पर तैयार हो गए थे, पर वो जो उनके जो एक्सीडेंट वगैरह हुआ वो उसकी वजह से, उसके बाद से कांग्रेस में कोई लीडरशिप ही नहीं है. सोनिया गांधी, राहुल गांधी एज सच लीडर नहीं है, वो मैनेजर अच्छे हो सकते हैं जो दूसरों के हेल्प से, उनके एडवाइजर्स वगैरह की उससे वो सरकार चला रहे हैं, पर एज ए मास लीडर सोनिया गांधी भी नहीं है और राहुल गांधी भी नहीं है. तो जब आगे वो जो एक चीज़ राहुल गांधी ने खुद कहा कि ज्योतिरादित्य सिंधिया को अपना फ्यूचर नहीं दिख रहा था कांग्रेस में, वो सही है. लीडरशिप ऐसी है नहीं कि वो आगे आपको इंस्पायर कर सके कि आप इस पार्टी में आपका फ्यूचर है.
इंटरजेक्ट अ बिट, यू नो, आई डिसएग्री अ लिटिल ऑन सोनिया गांधी.
2004 द ऑड्स वर कंप्लीटली
स्टैक्ड अगेंस्ट
हर.
शी डिड, शी वाज एक्सेप्टेड एज अ लीडर. आई मीन डिस्पाइट ऑल द कैंपेन अगेंस्ट हर फॉरेन ओरिजिन एंड एवरीथिंग, आई मीन, यू नो, आई मीन, यू हैव टू गिव इट टू हर, शी लेड फ्रॉम द फ्रंट लाइक अ लीडर.
बट एट दैट टाइम द अदर पर्सन ऑन द अदर साइड
उससे पहले जब सीताराम केसरी कांग्रेस के प्रेसिडेंट थे, कांग्रेस की 6 सीट कम थी.
शी वेंट ऑन द जनादेश यात्रा लोन काइंड ऑफ लीडर फ्रॉम द कांग्रेस, एंड आई मीन व्हाट शी फॉट अगेंस्ट, आई डू, दैट वाज रियली हर मोमेंट ऑफ ग्लोरी.
गांधीज का एडवांटेज ये है कि वो कांग्रेस को एकजुट रख सकते हैं, बस सिर्फ वो इसलिए वो लीडर हैं, वो एक्सेप्ट किया है, कांग्रेस ने लीडर एक्सेप्ट किया है, मासेस ने नहीं किया है, वहाँ पे डिफरेंस है। तो कांग्रेस की लीडर्स तो हो सकती हैं क्योंकि कोई और ऑप्शन नहीं है गांधी के अलावा, पर एज मास लीडर न सोनिया गांधी हैं न राहुल गांधी हैं। राहुल गांधी में वो पॉलिटिक्स की वो जो एक होना चाहिए वो चीज़ है ही नहीं, वो खुद भी एक्सेप्ट करते हैं उसमें वो नहीं है, जो एक हमारे यहाँ जो ट्रेडिशनल पॉलिटिशियंस हैं जिस तरह के वैसे वो नहीं है। नरेंद्र मोदी या अमित शाह जो 24/7 पॉलिटिक्स करते हैं, तो बाकी और भी हैं। हाँ, तो ये प्रॉब्लम अभी कांग्रेस में है, कांग्रेस कैडर बेस्ड पार्टी नहीं है। तो और जब कैडर नहीं होगा, लीडर भी नहीं होगा, तो पावर भी नहीं होगा, तो कैसे आगे उनको इंस्पिरेशन के लिए कुछ तो चाहिए जो लीडर्स हैं। इसीलिए जो सेकंड लाइन ऑफ लीडरशिप है वो बहुत ज़्यादा इम्पेशेंट है अभी, क्योंकि उनको आगे कुछ दिख नहीं रहा है। और जिस तरह की लीडरशिप बीजेपी में है वो बहुत ही एग्रेसिव है, प्रोएक्टिव है।
करेक्ट।
तो वो अप्रोच कर रहे हैं, उसमें जो फंस जाए वो ठीक है, उनके लिए तो अच्छा है, उनके लिए तो एडवांटेज है।
क्विकली लास्ट वर्ड फ्रॉम यू।
The basically thing is that I like to first set the record straight. Mr. Sindhia, Madhav Rao Sindhia came to the Congress when Congress was getting into power in 1980. You know, there was a very famous India Today cover at that point of time which said that when Raebareli elections were to take place, Indira Gandhi was contesting from Raebareli again, apart from Medak. And it said Mrs. Gandhi versus Mrs. India versus Mrs. Sindhia. She was, you know, the other candidate. And, you know, now it is the same. Kind of a role is being repeated. Secondly, you know, Madhav Rao Sindhia left the party when Narasimha Rao, you know, had made things difficult for him. He formed his own party. He returned back to the Congress when Congress came back to power. Was on the threshold of coming
party,
back to power.
Party bhi tabhi
he had hoped that he will be made the Prime Minister. And, you know, in 1999, when the government fell, Vajpayee's government by one vote, Sonia Gandhi had told President Narayanan that she wanted Manmohan Singh. When she and she had the, her famous remarks were 272. I mean, it was Madhav Rao who basically, according to Fauzedar, who went to Amar Singh and made Mulayam Singh to, you know, take back withdrawal support. So, you know, there are power games there. Now, finally, the thing is that in this Rajya Sabha election, Congress has not learned lessons. The next election is Bihar. There should have been either Shatrughan Sinha or Tariq Anwar who should have been granted tickets to Rajya Sabha. Those who can, you know, speak the Congress line in Bihar elections. Now there's nobody. All these people who have been, you know, given tickets, they are, you know, not going to be of any use in Bihar elections. So the party does not plan, the party does not think. And as long as the status quo-est politics of Sonia Gandhi continues, the party is going to be on its downhill journey.
Status quo-est politics of Sonia Gandhi to be replaced by, well, Rahul Gandhi's politics, that's really the future that the Congress has. It really needs to rethink, rejuvenate, and if not get a new leader, at least reinvent the leader that they have that is in keeping with the times. Otherwise, we may see a whole lot more people leaving along with Jyotiraditya Sindhia. We are already hearing talks of some of the names, but that's for another time. That's it for now. Thank you for watching this show. We'll see you again same time next week.
For more such videos, subscribe to the NewsX YouTube channel, hit the bell icon.